I want to welcome you to Dream Chasers Radio with me, your host, Yaya Diamond. Hey, people, what's up? How you doing? Oh, my gosh. So, look, this is a wonderful time to be alive. We are still here. We're still here. And so I am just thankful to still be here. And I want to thank you for being here with me. Don't forget to like and subscribe and comment and do all those good things while we take a short moment and a pause, because we have a great, great interview for you today. And don't you go nowhere. We'll be right back. We have a great show for you today. So we have an artist on the show. It's been a minute since I've had a recording artist on the show. I'm kind of missing my people here. So we have a wonderful, wonderful artist on the show today, and I want to welcome him to the show. Thank you so much for being on the show, Mr. Sullivan. What's up?
How you doing? Thank you for having me.
Oh, thank you for being on the show, man. Tell me all about yourself and how you got started.
Well, I'm 40 years old. I'm a single father. I started singing basically when I was 3 years old. And throughout my life, I continued singing. You know, I grew up with a musical background. My father, well, my grandfather, I apologize, he attended Bethune Cookman University in Daytona Beach. He was part, he was over the jazz ensemble, but as well as he had a band. And my mother, you know, she grew up singing young for his band. So I believe basically my musical talent, you know, first and foremost, it came from God, but I think I received it from my mom, you know, and my grandfather.
Wow. Bethune Cookman. I haven't heard that name in so long. Wow. So they were destined to be together.
Yes. I kind of believe, you know, like, just like I say, throughout my life, I started singing young, but, you know, growing up, I wanted to be, you know, the next Luther, the next, you know, I idolized so many R&B singers to where I thought I was going to be the next R&B singer. And it turned out to not be that way. You know, it turned out for me to be singing for the Lord like I should have been doing all my life.
Mm-hmm. It's so amazing how our lives don't really end up like our parents' lives. You know, we go our own different way. Sometimes it does, but most of the time it doesn't. It doesn't always follow that pattern. You know, you said you wanted to be the next Luther, but what changed your direction? What made you move towards the gospel and stay there instead?
Well, it took a while. Honestly, you know, being honest, you know, I battled with it for so many years to where, you know, it was often known, you know, I battled with church and I battled with the world, you know, so it took a long time. You know, I guess basically I grew up. It took for me to get like older to realize that I should be singing for God.
Mm. So the knowledge of and your understanding and getting older and maturing helped you to understand where you truly needed to be. That is just, that's wonderful. I love that. So tell me about your journey. Once you knew where you were supposed to be, was it easier then for you to kind of fall into that place?
Believe it or not, it truly was. You know, like I got a saying that I learned, and it says like doubt kills dreams more than failure ever will. And for so long, I felt like I was failing. Mm. I was like, I couldn't understand, you know, I didn't know why. I got a voice like, God, why am I not making it in the world? Like, what's wrong? Like, but then I had to evaluate myself and see. And then once I realized that, hey, let me try. Let me truly, honestly try. Let me try the same for God and see what it would really, truly do. And ever since I've been fully doing it, it's been nothing but a blessing.
People have a misconception that being in the music industry is different if you're a gospel recording artist or if you're a regular recording artist. I know that it's different because of the style of music that you do sing. But is the music industry kind of similar on both ends?
I truly believe somewhat it is, but for me, the best part about me choosing God over anything is that I don't have to, I can be myself. Mm-hmm. I can be Danny Sullivan. I don't have to worry about what someone thinks about me or, you know, or do I have to compete with what people have or show what I have? that's not my purpose. God showed me that all I have to do is just sing for him, give him all the praise and all the glory, and he'll show me favor.
Right. That's amazing. You know, the experience of everybody from one person to the next is totally different. When you look at your experience, though, what is different? Something that you didn't expect to have happen to you happen.
Okay. Well, I know being in the world and singing for the world, I was able to meet a lot of famous people. And I was like, basically to meet a very lot of famous people. I was blessed to even open up for some. But one thing I never gained from being in the world is that the fact of me singing for the Lord within 11 days, you know, God blessed me. Like 11 days, 6 different states, 553 spins in 11 days. Mm. Like I never had that when I was singing in the world. My song, not one song I ever had ever got spun on the radio.
Wow.
I've sung at clubs, I've opened up for people, but I've never gotten the recognition I have now. So that's why, like with my first single, Follow You, I'm going to continue to follow God, point blank, period.
It's important to actually settle into who you really truly are and to display that to other people. I feel like people really truly need to see who we are and to be who they really are. And, you know, I value that experience that you've had, because I've had something, sort of similar. So when you think about your new song, though, now, let's just go right into the music. When you go and you think about your new song, tell me about that song. And did you write it? I mean, tell me the history behind that.
Yes, I wrote it. That song, for so long, I doubted myself. You know, I've been a praiser. I know how to have a one-on-one with God. So, you know, with my journey, with singing, you know, I consider myself a slow song singer. I never thought that I had the ability to be able to write an upbeat song. But one thing I've learned, you know, with me, and, you know, like I say, I can always be honest with my path and me growing in God. God showed me something in 2018. In 2018, I went through a windshield and I saw the outside. You know, alcoholism, I battled with that for a long time. It got the best of me. And I saw the other side. You know, a lot of people can say, but you actually have to go through it. And like looking at me now, you wouldn't even be able to tell half the things that I went through in my life. But I feel like once I saw that other side, that right there showed me, Danny, wake up. It's like now or never. You need to try. Get a better understanding. And I promise God, like if I can make it out of that, I will follow him. And 3 years later, Follow You came about.
Wow. If you would permit, can we talk about you coming out of alcoholism? You know, I know that the song, I know that your promise to the Most High, you know, to God was something that kind of made, you know, made you come out of that. But I mean, ultimately, there might be people going through that right now. What do you tell them? You know, what kind of experience can you give them that will help them to understand that they too need to come out of alcoholism?
First and foremost, you gotta be real with yourself. You gotta understand and know the first step is admitting, like, hey, I got a problem. You know, everybody deals with different problems, whether it's alcohol or whatever problem that you're dealing with, period. You have to come to grips with yourself and understand. Once you understand your problem, then you'll be able to receive from other people that really care about you. And I learned to start receiving. I learned to start listening and start making better choices. You know, the difference between succeeding and failing is the decisions that you make. So you gotta listen. You gotta understand, admit to yourself. Once you admit to yourself, it's not going to happen overnight, but you'll get a better understanding and you'll be able to come to grips. And like I say, your receivers will be open, period.
Wow. Was there ever a moment in this journey that you felt like as if you were alone, that you were the only one in the world going through this specific, you know, trial, tribulation?
Yeah, I did in 2013. You know, I lost one of my sons.
I'm so sorry.
He was born premature. He lived for a month. And Like when he passed, it was, you know, I doubt it. You know, like I say, I've established that saying and I strongly believe it now, you know, that doubt kills dreams more than failure ever will. You know, I went to doubting, you know, I lost a son. I went to questioning God. I went to turning up, you know, I turned that bottle up. I didn't care. It got so bad to where I even I never got to the point to where I never wanted to hurt myself, but I just was mad at the world, you know, like we all do when we have habits. We always play the victim.
Wow, I'm so sorry to hear about that. You know, we all go through some certain, you know, some really, really trials and tribulations in our lives, and that is, I went through that. I don't want to go through that again.
The hardest part, I apologize, but it's just,
no, it's okay.
The hardest part about that was for him to live for a month. I think I would have took it, you know, maybe if he would have passed, you know, being born, but for me to get to know him, you know, Ronald McDonald House, losing a job, staying, going every day. And then that 30th day, they tell you like he on life support, you know, you have to make a decision, you know, but like I say, it's a lot, but I try to thank God every day. And basically with me, everybody is going to understand and they're going to see, you know, my life in my writing, the way I write my songs. Like at the end of the day, my songs are all based off of things that I've been through. And I'm just trying to show the world like how I praised him. And maybe somebody that's going through similar, they'll look at me and say, hey, this guy's been through the same thing. You know, he's not perfect. He's not making himself to be perfect. He's growing in his faith. He's still growing in his religion. But at the same time, I can follow too.
Yes. So your music is more than just music. Your music is you. It's your life.
Yes.
How does that make you feel when you put yourself on the line like that and be so transparent in front of the world?
It doesn't bother me. You know, I used to be pride, you know, that's a saying too. I was a very prideful person, but once I learned humility, I learned that nothing else matters. You know, I learned that at the end of the day, he has the last say so. So I'm not afraid to tell the world what I've been through because like I said, at the end of the day, I'm not doing this to make myself become popular. I'm not doing this to try to, you know, to be something I'm not. I'm doing this because at the end of the day, my life was already written. God showed me through all the things that I've been through what my purpose is in life. So I'm doing this to try to save every single soul that was lost just for me. So I don't have a shame or a care in the world what people feel or think about me. One thing I hope and I pray that they respect the fact of me being honest. I'm giving you the real me. I'm not giving you a made up Danny, not a clone Danny, not a, I'm just giving you me.
That's important. Wow. Thank you so much for sharing your life and your pain and your struggles. I think that, you know, as we mature and get older, even though, you know, some people mature at a very young age and some people don't, I think that maturity comes wisdom, you know, and that wisdom can be passed on. And I really, truly thank you so much for passing on your wisdom to those people who really need it, you know? Okay, so let's talk about your song. Okay, because we're getting ready to play that song. But before we do, what is the one thing that you say that you live by that maybe can help someone else?
Positive purpose, positive situation. Basically, keep yourself surrounded around positive people, positive purpose, and positive situation. As long as you can do that, nothing else is going to matter. That's for me for all of 2021. Positive people, positive situations, and always have a positive purpose. You can't lose.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. So I want you to introduce your song, but before you do, I want to thank you guys so much for tuning in to Dream Chasers Radio. We're getting ready to play some music. So go ahead, Mr. Sullivan, you do your thing. Go.
All right. Thank you, guys. This is my very first single. You know, my name again is Danny Sullivan. It's called Follow You. I hope you guys like it. If you want to reach me, you can reach me on all my social media platforms, which are attached to the label cbgmusicoutlet.com. And once again, this is my very first single, Follow You. Thank you.
Yeah. Come on, everybody, stand up. Stand on your feet. Let's get it.
Come on.
Put your hands together. In your face. Stand up and pray.
Yeah.
Come on.
Even though it may get crazy, Lord, I will follow you. No matter what's going on, you say me. Yes, I will follow you. Even though when things go wrong, you're right there by my side. You never let me go. It's because of you I'm alive. You've given me everything. That's why I worship you. No one can take away all the love I have for you. I'm gonna follow you. No matter what I go through, yes, I will follow you. We'll follow you. Even though it things get crazy, Lord, I will follow you. Lord, I will follow you. Lord, I will follow you. Yes, I will follow you. Lord, I will follow you. Lord, I will follow you. Yes, I will follow you. Lord, I will follow you. Even though when things go wrong, you're right there by my side. You never let me go. It's because of you I'm alive. You've given me everything. That's why I worship you. No one can take away all the love I have for you. I'm gonna follow you. No matter what I go through, yes, I will follow you. And I will follow you. And if I die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take. And if I die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take. Even though it things get crazy, Lord, I will follow you. Lord, I will follow you. No matter what's going on, you say me. Lord, I will follow.
I dare to be different. I dare to be different. I dare.